Put the world's most powerful leaders in the one place at the one time, and the first together are protesters. Thousands are using the unique opportunity presented by the APEC summit in Sydney to draw attention to their radical causes. Dimity Clancey has this report. Police were out in force today as the largest APEC protest took to the streets of Sydney CBD. The police message was clear: intimidation through large numbers. And it worked, keeping the violence to a minimum. 17 arrests were made throughout the day and two police officers sustained minor injuries.
Get back! Get back, I said!
The Stop Bush Coalition dominated the protest and had the most to say.
Australia, unfortunately, also has blood on their hands with the slaughter of 600,000 Iraqis that has resulted with this brutal occupation.
Their main focus was President Bush and Prime Minister Howard's relationship and their decisions on the Iraq War.
This is what we're fighting for!
We've made it clear all along that we are not interested in a physical confrontation with the police. We're here to get our message across peacefully by the weight of large numbers.
A riot control truck equipped with a water cannon was called in but was not used.
The reason the biggest protest of the summit is being held today is because this is the day the 21 world leaders meet. And tonight, the world's most powerful man, US President George Bush, heads home. Dimity Clancey reporting.